Alright, so game 7, Kraken and Stars tonight. The Kraken fell just short of winning their second playoff series in franchise history. As a Kraken hater myself, I must say I'm glad to see them lose, but I also have to say that you just have to respect their absolute grit and dedication for the game and their next man up mentality. Like, their top goal scorer, McCann, their only 40 goal scorer, was out for all of the first round, and yet they still managed to knock off the reigning cup champions with what was described as 4 second lines, which is just absolutely incredible. Definitely showing that with enough depth and hard work, anything's possible. Also, I'm trying to hit 100 subs right now, so if you want to hit that sub and like button right away, I'll be much appreciated. Anyways, back to the Stars and Kraken series. Early on in the series, it seemed as though the Kraken had figured out Ottinger, as they had 5, 6, and 7 goal outings in their 3 wins against the Stars. But after a 6-3 win in Game 6, with Ottinger getting pulled after allowing 4 goals on 18 shots, he was looking to bounce back in Game 7, and bounce back he did. It was a tight game right from the start, with both teams trying to get the opening goal without giving up too many opportunities for the other team. And just 4 minutes into the first, Miro Heiskanen rings a shot off the post from the point. Just a side note, Heiskanen is just an absolute stud on the Dallas blue line, as he's averaging 25 to 30 minutes of ice time per night while being a premier two-way defenseman. Later in the first, Dallas had another scrum in front of the net, but couldn't cash in and bang the puck home as it somehow stayed out. There were a couple of rest chances back and forth, but nothing too dangerous, and with the shots tied 9-9 at the end of the first, the score was 0-0. About 7 minutes into the second period, Oleksiak picks up a loose puck at the point and absolutely rockets a shot past Ottinger, ringing it off the iron as the game remains scoreless. About 8 minutes left in the second, Sagan gets a nice bump pass from Marchman at the blue line, toe drags past the Seattle defender and is all alone in on Grubauer but can't finish the deal, and the game remains scoreless. About 4 minutes left in the second, Dallas flips it out to the neutral zone, a bit out of reach of Oleksiak. Even with his long frame, he still can't get at the puck in time, and Hintz steals it, goes around him, rips down the wing, and wrists a shot far side on Grubauer, who wasn't up to the challenge, making it a 1-0 Dallas game, getting the crowd absolutely buzzing. The second ended 1-0, as Hintz's 18th point of the playoffs tied him with Leon Draisaitl, and put him just 2 points back of McDavid for the point lead in the playoffs. After a back-and-forth game, with about 7 minutes left in the third, Dadonov flips the puck the length of the ice, which would have been an icing if not for Wyatt Johnson, the speedy youngster, getting to it first. Picks the puck out of the corner and goes to the backhand and absolutely roofs it short side on Grubauer, making it 2-0 for the Stars. Just a display of some absolute silky mitts to get that puck from ice level to top shelf and snap. That goal gave him the goal lead for rookies with his 4th this postseason. Just a couple minutes later, Schwartz centers the puck into the slot, and Bjorkstrand absolutely wires a shot that also hits the crossbar, yet another iron rung in this game. Bjorkstrand would get the best of Ottinger though, as with just 17 seconds left off the draw, he does backhand a shot in off the slot, making it a 1-goal game. But it was too little too late, and the game ended 2-1 for the Stars as they took Game 7 and head on to the next series, which is taking on the Knights in the Western Conference Final. So yeah, mad respect to the Kraken, defeating the defending Stanley Cup champs and pushing this series to 7 as well. Definitely more than anybody had them doing in any hockey bracket anywhere. I would call it historic if not for some other expansion team getting to the cup final in their inaugural year, but that's a story for a different video. But yeah, if you like this content, feel free to sub and hit the like button on your way out, and I'll see you in the next one. Peace.
It ends up in the corner. Ben has the puck, clears the zone. Game 7 is over.